Propinquity Court is not alone in recording a catalogue of actions. Many streets, yards, gardens and courts in the Palatine Approaches become the site of multiple, contradictory battles, often overlapping, often without strategic sense, as those loyal forces left outside the walls, those life-sellers, attempt to frustrate the enemy advance. Like the bodies of the loyal Astartes dead, the actions are not remembered, nor their significances noted. War has little or no memory. Feats of extraordinary prowess that would, in other times and other places, have been recorded and celebrated, are finished and forgotten, even before the next wave of violence sweeps through. Crunching obliviously over the bones of the valorous and the defeated alike. In the final ever hours of the siege, such deeds and achievements take place that would fill 1,000 books and swell the honored archives of Terran military history, but all are lost and unremembered, as ghosts in the fog and smoke of that tumult. Bödvar Bjarki gets back up again. There's blood in his eyes, and most of it is his own. The last impact lacerated his head so deeply, his scalp is torn open. At Narfa's Crossing, on the Delphic Edge, loyalist units have been holding back the enemy advance for 3 straight hours, though time seems to have lost the definition it once had. Their numbers have dwindled with every transpertine thrust the Death Guard makes. Bjarki, Heaper of Corpses, and one of the very few warriors of the 6th Legion Space Wolves active on Terra, feels like he's one of the last defenders standing at Narvis. Flexing his grip on his blade with blood-slick hands, he looks around. He's not one of the last at all. He is the last. Warhorns boom. He can hear the shrill warble of melters and smell the stink of cooking stone. 3 times has he fought back the enemy bastards from the top of the mound of bodies piled at the north end of the bridge. 3 times he's been struck from the apex of that corpse hill. Each time he's clambered back up to hold the ridge of snapped bone and torn flesh. There have been few warriors with him. But Bjarki's Fred is not yet cut. And though there are no scalds to sing it, his saga is not done. Not yet. He spits and invokes the spirits of Fenris, the dark and silent slip of not wolves running the black and white forests. He starts to climb the bodies again. He'll make it 4 times, 5, as many times as it takes, or as many times as he has left. There are no wolves on Terra, but in the name of Russ, he will be a one man rout. Bödvar Bjarki served as a rune priest of the Space Wolves during the Great Crusade and Horus Heresy. Present during the Burning of Prospero, as his legion drove the Thousand Suns from their homeworld, his service within the Third Great Company earned him the notice of Malcadore the Sigilite. Assigned to recover shards of the broken Crimson King, Magnus the Red, Bödvar, alongside the Ultramarines' chief librarian, Dio Promus, Antaka Saivan, and Yasu Nagasena, by denying the Thousand Suns their Primarch's essence, their involvement in the civil war would be severely lessened. Confronting the Cabal of Ahriman upon the world of Nykea, Promus attempted to combat a shard of Magnus, the last samurai of Terra, Nagusena protecting the Ultramarine from harm, as demons swarmed his immobile form. Taunted by Kairos Fateweaver as chaos erupted, Bödvar listened to the Fatewoven's claims that Promus had murdered loyalist Astartes during his mission to assemble candidates for the Knights Errant, purging those deemed too weak to join their cause. Admitting to his crimes before Bödvar, the rune priest cut down the chief librarian before witnessing the binding of a shard of Magnus into the form of the Remembrancer, Lemuel Gomon. Adopting the name Promius, derived from the slain Ultramarine to mark his ascension, Bödvar regarded his friend as a weird wraith, imbued with great psychic power and unable to be possessed by demons. Though they had failed to claim the shard for Malcador's purposes, they had at least denied one to the enemy, the remainder retrieved by the Thousand Suns as they attempted to restore their liege. Studying Promius prior to the invasion of the traitors, This psychic savant proved crucial during the Siege of Terra in aiding Bödvar and the Salamander Trio, Atok Abidemi, Eigen Gargo, and Barak Zytos. Defending the Western Hemispheric Wall alongside his two surviving packmates, Bödvar repelled the Thousand Suns' assault by combining the summoned psychic essence of Fenris and Noctunre with aid from Abidemi. Repelling Magnus the Red for a time, Bjarki's overloaded psychic senses refused to release him from their control, forcing Abidemi to sever Bodvar's arm to break the connection. Tracking Magnus as he infiltrated the Imperial Palace, alongside Promius and the Salamanders, Bödvar and his comrades in arms fought at the side of the Drake Lord, Vulkan, within the throne room of the Emperor. Defeating Arzak Ahriman in single combat due to the chamber's warp dampening wards, the exile retreated with his Primarch, with his total surrender to the Changer of Ways. The sole survivor of his pack, Bjarki laid to rest his kinsman and the fallen salamander, Barak Zytos, marking a drake's head on his armor to remember the valiant son of Noctunre. Joining forces with Garviel Loken and Nathaniel Garrow as the siege continued to escalate, Bjarki fought on against the Death Guard Legion within the Delphic battlements. The one-man rout of terror, fighting until the end as a champion of the Wolf King and Avenger of the Sigilite.